Hello, this is Harry Norman for Proactive Investors, and welcome to another Proactive audio interview. Today is the 26th of November 2009, and I'm talking with John Sutcliffe, Managing Director of Mariana Resources, listed on the AIM market mining sector. Stock ticker MARL, share price 19 pence, market cap £22.8 million sterling. Web address marianaresources.com. John, thank you very much for joining us for this interview.
That's a pleasure, Harry.
Please give investors a brief introduction to Mariana Resources, the Deseado Massif in Patagonia, and the Atacama Fault Zone in Chile.
Mariana is an AIM-quoted exploration and development company with projects in South America. In Argentina, the company's focus is the Deseado Massif, an area roughly the size of Wales, which has produced approximately 8 major discoveries in the last 10 to 15 years. We have 2 projects in the Deseado, Sierra Blanca and Dos Calandrias, which are 100% projects, and we have a joint venture with Hochschild Mining on what we refer to as the Amigos project. In Chile, the company is actively exploring the Atacama Fault Zone for copper mineralization of the type known as IOCG, which stands for iron oxide copper gold. The company has 2 projects in the fault zone, and we have recently completed drilling on both properties. Both areas, Argentina and Chile, where the company is operating, permit all the year round work in. It's a very efficient place for a junior company to get involved, and we've had considerable success in both areas. We in Mariana are very proud of our exploration teams in Chile and Argentina. In Argentina, the team is headed by Dr. Gustavo Rodriguez, an experienced PhD geologist. In Chile, the team is headed by Walter Espinosa, one of the senior members of the exploration community in Chile, ex-Barrick country manager. And also you'll see the board of Mariana all have a strong exploration background, and all members of the board have been involved in very significant discoveries.
Mariana has made a gold-silver discovery at the Dos Calandrias project in Patagonia, involving a type of mineralization previously undiscovered there, with bulk tonnage potential. What does this mean for investors?
Well, it's very early days in terms of exploration, but we've had some very exciting results from Dos Calandrias, large intersections of between 0.5 gram and 3 to 4 grams, which do indicate the possibility of some bulk mining potential. Obviously, we're going to have to prove that up with ongoing exploration, but at this stage, it looks, yes, indeed, a very encouraging development.
Mariana has just entered a joint venture with one of its major shareholders, Hochschild Mining, to explore and develop properties in Patagonia. What are the terms of this joint venture, and how prospective are these properties, John?
Hochschild, as you know, are investors in Mariana. We've developed a very friendly relationship with Hochschild over the last 18 months, and this joint venture came about when we were approached by Hochschild, who had a property adjacent to our Amigos concession. And basically, it appears that the mineralization straddles the 2 properties, so we put our heads together and decided to combine the 2 properties into a joint venture, which is 51-49. Mariana pays 40% of the costs in the first 3-year period, so we do get a partial carry. And we are planning to start drilling there in the next few months. We have surface silver values on our property, on the Amigos concession, of over 400 grams per ton of silver, which is getting on for 0.5 kilo. That's a very significant silver content. We don't know what's going to happen in depth, but we are dealing with an epithermal vein system, and we are hoping for some indications of bonanza silver grades and also possibly some high gold grades. In the property immediately to the north of the joint venture area, Hochschild are currently conducting a drill program, and we believe that they are meeting with some success there.
Would you like to bring us up to speed on the Sierra Blanca gold discovery in Patagonia?
Yes, well, you may have seen the recent press release in which we announced the acquisition of IAMGOLD's 30%. IAMGOLD really are stepping out of the joint venture because it is essentially a silver project, and IAMGOLD, as their company name suggests, is essentially a gold mining company. Silver is outside of their commodity objective. So we have reached terms where we are going to acquire IAMGOLD's 30%. This is a cash and share-based deal. And this will permit Mariana to go forward with a very aggressive drill program, which will commence immediately following the Dos Calandrias drilling. We expect that drilling would start in Sierra Blanca in the second quarter of 2010.
Mariana is waiting on drilling results from the Pero Chico and Buenaventura iron ore copper gold projects, both of which are in Chile. Would it be misplaced to hope for news of high grades on these projects?
Yes, the sort of target that we're looking for, what we call the IOCG or iron oxide copper gold project, typically does not contain exceptionally high copper grades. They are very large volume deposits, something like the dimensions of porphyry coppers. Grades typically run in the 0.5 to 1% copper range. We will be announcing the results of that drill program in the coming weeks.
Mariana Resources has just closed a placing, raising $2.9 million at a premium to its share price. How will these funds be applied, and what is Mariana's financial situation going forward, John?
Yes, well, the raising of approximately £2.9 million puts Mariana in a very favourable position for a small junior exploration company. It will permit us to drill three properties in 2010. And as we go forward, on the back of exploration results, we would probably be looking at further financing sometime in 2011. But certainly for the immediate future, we have sufficient funds to carry out ongoing exploration forward. 50% roughly of the funds will be directed towards the projects in the Deseado Massif and the balance in Chile and, of course, in our corporate costs.
What news flow can investors expect from Mariana over the next 12 to 18 months, John?
Yes, so there's going to be, I would say, a fairly steady news flow, drilling with three projects in Argentina and further drilling in Chile. The first developments will be around Dos Calandrias, which is where we're directing all of the initial effort. There is at the moment an ongoing geophysical program which will lead to target definition and the commencement of drilling in the first quarter of next year. This will be followed by drilling at Sierra Blanca, starting immediately after the Dos Calandrias drilling, I would say sometime around about April next year. Both projects will generate a steady news flow as results come in. And then we shall be drilling with Hochschild, drilling in the Amigos joint venture area. Again, this will yield a steady news flow. That drilling is expected to commence in the second quarter of 2010. And I believe we can look forward to further work on our copper project in Chile, again, with news flow probably associated with some follow-up drilling.
Remember, Proactive Investors is not an investment advice service. Make sure you register at proactiveinvestors.co.uk for our weekly newsletter, which will keep you informed about our articles, interviews, and events. Thank you for listening. Please note, I hold shares in Mariana Resources.